In this video, I'm going to give you the best export settings for uploading your videos to YouTube inside of iMovie so that you don't lose any quality and so it doesn't take hours to upload. Coming up.
You got to just press record.
Hey guys, my name is Nolan with Think Media, and recently I posted a video on how to upload your videos faster to YouTube, and I talk about some Wi-Fi tips as well as going in depth on YouTube's recommended settings for uploading straight to YouTube. Now, if you haven't seen that yet, make sure you click on the card and check that out. Now, in that video, I got a lot of questions on people wondering how to do it in iMovie and the best export settings for doing that in iMovie, and so that is what I'm going to be talking about today. Without further ado, let's get into the video. So now that we're inside of iMovie, I have a simple project. It's one 55 second long clip, and we'll just kind of pretend that this is my fully edited video. You know, it's gonna be the same process here. So there's two ways really to do this. Over here, we have this button. This is the share button. There are some options here, okay? And if you don't have that, or you wanna go this way, you can go to File, Share, and you're gonna have the same options over here. And so the two that I'm gonna share in this video is File as well as YouTube. So we're gonna start with File. And what this is a file is going to export your video to your computer. And from there, you can then go to youtube.com and upload that video, which is the new video you exported to the computer. You can upload that to your YouTube channel. So let's go through these settings. I'm gonna show you exactly what resolution, quality, compression to do to have the best quality and so that it doesn't take forever. So we'll start by changing the name to video one. And under tags and stuff, we can leave all this. It doesn't really matter. This is just gonna help in your Finder if you wanna find it later, but we're not gonna use this, so I'm not gonna mess with it, I'm not gonna change it, doesn't really matter. Format, you wanna make sure video and audio, of course audio only will just be your audio, so we're gonna have video and audio selected. Under resolution, we have some options here. I'm gonna leave mine at 4K, but you can definitely make it 1080 if you'd like, and you can see that makes it smaller and that's gonna be a faster upload for you. So 4K does not matter. And if you imported 1080 footage, then you're not probably gonna have the option for 4K anyways. iMovie is going to automatically see that it is 1080 video and you can select 1080. For this example, I'm gonna go to 4K to get that extra resolution. When it comes to quality, we have low, medium, high, best, ProRes, and custom. Now, if I hit best ProRes, take a look at this number over here. It's gonna jump really, really high. So let's go to best. 3.3 gigabytes. That's crazy how much that changes. You know, 205 megabytes and then jumping up over 3 gigabytes. With the file being so large, it actually took me over an hour just to upload this 55 second video to YouTube. And I'll show you my internet speeds, you know, are not super fast, but they're just normal. And, but when I changed that from this best ProRes to high, which is what I recommend at 205 megabytes, it took 5 minutes to upload. And that's just crazy. And definitely what you wanna do when uploading, you want it to be quicker, definitely choose high. And also, if you're using best ProRes, that's gonna be a .mov, and YouTube's recommended encoding settings is actually for .mp4 anyways, which if we go to high, then that is going to be a .mp4. If you were uploading something that needed to be the best quality possible, and maybe you're uploading it to Vimeo because that's not going to compress it as much, then go with best ProRes. But honestly, you know, YouTube's gonna compress the file size anyways. So if I even used best ProRes, what I found through my test is there's not really a difference between these two. So we're gonna use high, and that's gonna be major in reducing the file size so that it can upload faster. Now, if you do wanna take a look at custom and increase this to get, you know, a little bit more quality, through my tests, once it's on YouTube, I could not see a difference between custom with this all the way up versus high. So that's why I choose high, just kind of some of my reasoning behind that. When it comes to compress, this is not for, you know, upload speed. This means faster to export. So to actually get your video from your editor to your desktop or wherever you're saving that. We want better quality, and so I'm gonna hit better quality, and it might take a little bit longer, but I'm totally okay with that to get the better quality. So follow these exact steps. From there, you can hit next and you can export it to wherever you'd like. So here we can see that it's brought the title up here. We could change it again if we'd like. And then I want mine to export to my desktop. So I'll just hit save and that is going to start exporting. From here, you're gonna see this circle in the upper right-hand corner. And when the circle fully encloses, that is when it's done. So you can see it's gonna take about 1 minute here. And when that video is then on my desktop, I can go to youtube.com, upload video, and I can just drag it from my desktop onto youtube.com and it will start uploading for me automatically. And boom, this circle has gone away and I get a notification from iMovie saying that my movie one was successful. And that's actually the name of this project. And so we could also change that to video one if I wanted everything to be named the same. When it comes down to it, exporting and uploading your videos to YouTube is really one piece of the puzzle when it comes to YouTube success. If you wanna make money on YouTube and go full-time on your dream job, then you need to join us and other serious content creators at Grow With Video Live. You'll not only learn how to start and grow a YouTube channel, but you'll get connected to a community of people who are going to support you. You can join us from anywhere in the world, so make sure to get your tickets today at growwithvideolive.com. I hope you guys are enjoying this video so far. Let us know down in the comments, what other questions do you have about YouTube content creation? We'd love to answer those questions in our next video. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Now, if you want to upload your video directly to YouTube, you can actually do this inside of iMovie. So the other way to do it is to click on our share button and then go to YouTube. Now, when we open up YouTube, when you first do this for the very first time, you're gonna have to connect your YouTube channel and you'll click, there'll be a button right here and you can actually connect your channel very easily. It takes like 15 seconds and you just open it up, you choose what profile, and then it is connected. Now here, there's some less options, so we'll kind of just go through it really fast. Resolution is at 4K. Again, same thing, you could change it to whatever is best for you, but I like to leave mine at the highest resolution. And then you can change your category, which that's just gonna be set to whatever your YouTube channel is. And then privacy, make sure you leave it on private or unlisted. If you want it to go public, then you could do that, but I definitely like to make it private or unlisted so I can go in, I can edit the description, I can add some end cards, and so we're gonna leave it on private. Here we can see that the file size is a little bit less, and I actually found that this method took about 4 minutes to upload to YouTube. And so because it is a bit of a smaller file size, it does upload a little bit quicker, and I actually didn't really see any noticeable difference between this way of doing it and uploading through exporting as a file. That being said, I actually don't love doing it this way. I actually like to do it the way that I showed you first, because you get that file on your computer. And I like to use that sometimes when I am talking in a YouTube video, maybe I'm referencing an old video. I like to have that file on my computer. If you upload directly to YouTube from iMovie, yeah, you're skipping a step because it gets to go straight to YouTube and you don't have to worry about exporting and then uploading. It's doing both of those in one step, but I like to have that file on my computer and it's about the same upload speeds and quality. And because of those reasons, that's why I prefer to use the file method. Now, if you wanna watch more tutorials on iMovie, then you can click on the screen right now. We have a bunch of tutorials that you can check out, learn something new. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys in the next one.